The Sailor 2021, you can find it on YouTube. It's a documentary and it's pretty darn good, actually. It's really got a mellow tone to it, kind of a sad tone to it. There's a great longing feeling in this movie. It's about a sailor, of course, who designed a boat and made most of his money off of selling the right to make other boats like it. But that was a long, long time ago, and they didn't actually say it, but he appears to have outlived his children. He had his children in the 1940s, and they're gone by the sounds of it. So this guy must be really quite old, It's got to be over 90, so close to 100 probably. If his kids were born in the 1940s, he's probably close to 100 years old. Anyways, still living on his boat in the I don't have any idea, though. I think it's the Caribbean islands. They made reference to the Caribbean anyways in one of the blurbs that you see on one of the TVs there. So that's where I'm assuming it's from. I didn't look it up to see, so I could be wrong. But yeah, it's a pretty good thing. He talks about his life. He's pretty sparse with the talk. It's mostly visual, but it's really quite nice. Yeah, 8 out of 10. A Street Cat Named Bob. Okay, so this is a true story, more or less, about a guy named James Bowen, who was a busker, and he lived on the streets and stuff, and he was a drug addict, and he sort of cleaned up his life and got things on track after he meets a stray cat, a stray ginger cat that he calls Bob. Yep, it's a feel-good movie, and it's not the greatest movie in the world. It just has a forced feel to it, but that being said, I'm gonna give this a 6 out of 10 because it's just such a feel-good. Okay, Whiplash, 2014. So this dude's a jazz drummer at Juilliard. And he's a first-year student, so he's not usually going to end up in this one guy's class because, first year and all, right? But he impresses the teacher, who's a hard-nosed, bully, negative reinforcement type. I mean, a real jerk, right? A complete and total jerk. So, he's trying to force the kid to have live up to his full potential and all this stuff, and there's a lot of up and down in this, a lot of emotional drain, a lot of heartbreak, and then in the end, there's a turnaround at the end, and it's something else. Really good, really awesome drum solo at the end of this film. Yebbers, that kind of ruined the ending, but it's just spectacular. Yebbers, 9 out of 10. Drive, 1997. Even now, YouTube is telling me it's 2022. It's not. YouTube has a huge problem of getting the dates wrong. They tend to stick the date on that they added the movie instead of the date the year it was made instead, But anyways, so this dude's a prototype enhanced human being. He's a superhuman basically. He escapes from the Chinese government who engineered him aboard a ship run by the Chinese mafia, and them and the bad guys from the United States try to capture him, of course, or kill him, and one or the other. Lots of trying to shoot him in the feet in this movie. Anyways, it's And lots of really, really bad shooting. If you can't shoot a guy with a machine gun from 15 feet away, you suck. But anyway, but anyways, bad guys are always bad shots. It's a pretty good movie. He teams up with this dude who's got dreadlocks, and he's a music writer and all that, an aspiring music writer that is, and they elude everybody for the rest of the movie, basically, until the conclusion, which is, a turnaround type thing. Anyways, pretty good movie. I'm gonna give it a 7 out of 10. Blue World Order 2012. No. Okay, this is an independent film, so you should cut it a little bit of slack, and that's what I did, and gave it a 3 out of 10 instead of a 1 out of 10. Anyways, yeah, end of the world, limited nuclear exchange, really bad bacteria killing off all the people, mad scientists, new world order, blah, 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 blah. Yippers. So, yeah, there's not much more to it, really, than all that nonsense. Yeah, 3 out of 10, not worth it. Firstborn, 2007. So, this guy and his wife move out to the country, into a big old house, escaping the city, kind of, so to speak. Laura, the wife, who's kind of resentful that she had to give up one of her dreams to, be out in the wilderness, the country, in the big house and all this, is also resentful that the husband really doesn't have much time for her. She has to have a C-section, and this kind of drives her crazy. She's seeing things. The husband hires a housekeeper to take care of the person to take care of the kid, that is. Well, she thinks the person is out to use magic to hurt the child and whatnot, and it just spirals out of control. Eventually, the housekeeper is replaced by the woman's mother, and she finds this doll that she thinks is causing all her troubles, and she decides to get rid of it, and that's when things really turn for the worse. Yippers! Not quite a pass. 4 out of 10.